So this is a drive with us, and we're going to, it says rotate your device, you can't turn, well, we don't want to turn it, so let's just leave it like that. And for those that are watching, you can go shopping with us. Well, not exactly shopping, but we're going to go to Mercator in Banja Luka, and we're about 15 to 20 kilometers outside. And when we start on the route to Banja Luka, if we get too much sun, because it's a sunny day today, then we'll have to switch off, because all you'll get is blinding sun. But we'll see how it goes. And we'll promise not to have too much of any domestic arguments or anything like that in the car.
Why would we have that?
I don't know. Because we're just normal people. So let's see if the sun... As you can see, the sun is...
Glaring.
At the moment. So I just thought this might be quite novel to just turn it that way a bit so that we get the sun out of it.
We have no snow, and we're going to have nice weather, apparently.
Tamara was watching TV this morning, and apparently...
It will be plus 17.
It's going to be plus 17 here.
In the next year.
Hello, Jules.
Today is 12, tells us.
Dai says, Borada. I told you what Borada meant yesterday. What does it mean?
Dobardan.
Dobardan, yeah, in Welsh. Is the sun too bright for you guys?
Can you see the road?
Can you see the road?
We're going to go now there, so it might be better.
Yeah, it might be a little bit better. Dai says it looks good. Thank you, Dai.
That's good.
But we're going to turn around now. What we're trying to do, I think the battery will hold out. Is I just thought it'd be a nice experiment, because see the sun? Yeah. How long does it take to get to the shopping centre?
30 minutes.
So it's about half an hour.
Depending on the traffic.
Depending on traffic. And it is New Year's Eve.
Oh, what's that going?
Today.
Dodgy. Where is it going?
For those that are watching, I wanted to say something. Yeah, for those... I'm trying to get the camera to be horizontal. If it's slightly off, I do apologize, but if anybody's watching this at all anywhere in the world and was here in the late 1990s to early 2000s and never came back, this road didn't exist then. Well, it did, but it, as you can see on the right, this hill was all cut away to make for this highway into Banja Luka. Oh, Jules, Happy New Year. They've just had the first of their fireworks.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you.
Time difference.
Oh,
yeah. All the best, Jules.
All the best to our Australian visitors. Anyway, so this is the what we call the transit. This goes for about 12 kilometres from near where we live into Banja Luka. And all things being equal, when we get there, you'll see the built-up area. And then we'll drive along the back road, as we call it, and we're going to go to one of the major shopping centres in the city. Tam is after sushi. She says, thanks, guys.
Love
midnight
sushi.
Fireworks to come soon. Great. We'll have fireworks in Banja Luka, and I suppose we'll have fireworks in a local town, so we might see some of those in the air, depending on... the weather. And if you follow the Facebook page, which you must be because you're watching this, you'll see that we posted a photograph from Thomas Damjanovic, who's a pretty cool videographer, photographer and dronographer, and he posted a picture earlier today, which is now on the Facebook page. They've built a massive stage. Is there any real celebrities coming this year?
Petr Grášo is coming from Croatia. Nada Kradin, which is an old singer. Like she's like my dad or something. Maybe a little bit.
So old people this year singing.
Yeah, Petar Grash is not old.
Right.
He is, and maybe he's like me. I don't know. Not too old, I suppose. And Anna Bekuta is coming the day after.
So two days of outside celebration.
Yes.
Cool. Paul Marshall, who's...
And I'm not sure, but apparently I heard this morning on the news, I'm not sure who's going to sing, but Belgrade is having a huge, huge party, and they have everything COVID ready, so you have to have, like, in Zagreb as well, so you have to have, like, a COVID passport, and they have a quick antigen test in the entrance.
So super safe in Belgrade and Zagreb.
Yes.
What about Banja Luka?
Not sure. We don't care anymore.
I want to say Happy New Year to Paul Marshall, who I think is in Adelaide. I'm sure I've got that wrong. I hope I haven't got that wrong. Paul, I know. Paul used to be here. He used to work here. So maybe a little bit of nostalgia for Paul today. But years ago, when I first came here and when Tamara grew up here, it used to be snow at this time of year, didn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, snow.
We used to have snow, but now with the climate change.
Yeah, climate change has ruined everything.
Yes, so no snow. Last year we had very little snow. We had some snow like a few days ago, but it melted right away. It's not like Canada, eh?
It's not like Canada. Nobody's woken up yet in Canada, by the way.
No.
Or I think maybe they were just waking up now.
Maybe, yeah.
So Paul, once again, thank you very much indeed. And thanks to everybody that's watching, even if you don't comment. We're up to about 620 followers now on the Facebook page. I want to try and get it up to about 1,000. And if you know of anybody that's from not only Bosnia and Herzegovina but the region that might be interested, you know, feel free to share the content.
And some travellers as well.
And people that want to travel. Talking about travelling, we've managed to. With Zoran Matic, who you might have heard a podcast of. Zoran has written the ultimate guide to Bosnia and Herzegovina, 50 top locations to visit. It's an amazing book, and he's got it translated into English, and we're now selling it. It's not expensive, actually, on the website, but more of that later, because we don't want to talk about selling things, do we?
No.
Today, because today is a buying day.
If you want
day.
To see all the 50 places, you will need at least 10 days in Bish.
Or
at
more.
Least, or 2 weeks.
Yeah, 2 weeks to see all the places.
Which is a relatively small country, so you can do a lot in 2 weeks.
So if anybody's got any questions today, while we're on this journey about Bosnia, Herzegovina, the weather.
So what is everyone eating for?
Yeah, what are you having for New Year's?
Are you having
we're having
some,
a vegan.
Are you having some meze?
Are we having veganism? Some? Are we having a...
We're going to have a vegan loaf. We're going to have a lentil.
Tamara's making a vegan loaf. We're going to have some sushi.
We're going to have some sushi, mushroom gravy. Sushi we're going to have for lunch, but for Christmas. For Christmas Eve. For New Year's Eve, we're going to have a lentil loaf with mashed potato and mushroom gravy.
Yep. Flexitarians, a little bit of this and a little bit of that.
Yeah, we eat more plants now than anything else. Which is not true on holidays because everybody around us eats carnivore.
Guess who's joined us from Canada?
Debbie.
No.
Who?
Jenny Desajon.
Oh, hello, Jenny. I didn't see Jenny.
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Yes. I don't know, whereabouts are you now in Canada, are you? New Year Drive with Canada. Yes, indeed. Jenny, you'll remember, because this is the road into Banja Luka from Laktashi, and when you were here, I don't think this road was so developed, but if you want to hang around, you'll see, she's in Quebec City. Okay, bonjour.
Bonjour, Quebec.
Hang around, Jenny, because you'll see the changes in Banja Luka from when you were here. Jenny and I worked together many years ago. Wow, must be 15 years ago, more.
A long time ago. And as you can see, Banja Luka is misty, very misty.
Yeah, it's got a haze over it today.
Apparently, a few days ago, Banja Luka was one of the most unhealthiest cities to be in.
Where?
Europe.
In Europe?
Yes. Air-wise. I mean, the quality of the air. So, I think that's the bad air. Thank God we live outside.
Yeah. How's the signal, guys? Is it still holding up? We've had some improvements in the data link. I hope I didn't say that too early.
Well, what improvements?
Can you put the window up, please, because it's so noisy now.
No, but I'm hot.
Can we put the...
It's the sun.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm boiling. It's very warm today, 15 Celsius now.
It's 15 Celsius. On New Year's Eve, this is unbelievable. We should have snow. We would normally have beautiful blue skies, but tons of snow, and it would be cold. Jules says that the data connection is very good. Sorry for the sun, can't do anything about that. So we're now approaching the outskirts of
Banja Luka
City.
Traffic is crazy because everyone is running away.
What people don't understand about being here where we live and what you're seeing now, this is heavy traffic. I mean, come on, if you lived in London, this is not heavy traffic.
Yes, for this small city, this is a heavy traffic. Very, very heavy.
And if you look at the yellow signs, for those that don't know, you'll see all the signs are in two alphabets, the Latin alphabet and Cyrillic. I don't know if you can see the yellow one with the sun, but it says Sarajevo in... I think you can read that, can't you? Yeah. It looks like Capajebo, but it isn't. It's Sarajevo.
It's warm.
Yeah, it's very warm in here.
Straight on my skin. And I have a winter jacket.
Yeah, well, I think we got this wrong today.
Do we? It's 14.5 Celsius, it says in my car.
How warm is it in Welsh Wales, Di, if you're still looking, watching? And how cold or hot is it in Quebec? That'd be interesting as well.
What about Sydney?
Sydney, it's nighttime now, so maybe a bit cooler.
Is it summer in Australia now?
Yeah.
Summertime, baby.
So we're going to buy some ingredients for our New Year's Eve
meatloaf
meal, and it's 23 in Sydney at the moment.
Wow.
Nice. Lucky you.
Yeah,
so we're gonna buy some food, and I'm most probably gonna buy a little bottle of champagne, and I'm gonna look in the tech shop.
He wants to buy a camera.
I don't want to buy a camera today.
What do you want to buy today?
I don't know. I'm actually thinking about buying a chair.
Chair?
Yeah. So not much longer, and we'll be off the transit, and then when we get into the city limits, I hope the sun won't be so strong so you can see more. I thought it was quite a good idea, drive with us.
Yeah. Hey, I want to know, guys, how's the prices where you live? We have experienced in the last 6 months huge increase in prices, especially in food. So, and gas as well.
But Bosnia is still cheap.
So, it's still very cheap, but I mean...
Put the window up a little bit.
It's still very cheap, but the prices are... Like, everything got so expensive, especially the food, I'm noticing.
How much is a loaf of bread now here?
Almost 2 marks, €1.
€1
for... Depending, it's even more, depending what type of loaf are you buying.
Di says in Wales they've had one sunny day in a month, and they have 13 degrees there. So yeah, so it's €1 for a loaf of bread, standard sliced bread here. That I still think is cheap, although the prices are going up here. So
yeah, you can buy cheaper ones actually, but also more expensive ones.
Fuel is $2 a litre in Australia.
Here is 225 marks.
225 marks, and how much is it a mark to
somewhere
the dollar?
225 neopoima. I have no idea.
No, I don't know what it is.
But it's like 220. So one euro and 10 cents.
Yeah, euro 10 cents for a liter of fuel here. He said same in Wales. Dyer says it's, you know, everything is going up. But I think maybe the thing, it is relative in a way. Having said that, this country is not as economically stable or economically successful for a whole number of factors, and we won't go into those today. But yeah.
Not one. Yeah, I mean the electricity.
Well, 75p, that's a pound. A pound is a euro,
I don't know,
and something. So it's a euro and something for a loaf. We're back on, and we've had to change the position. The previous part one of this drive, the phone actually switched off for safety reasons because it got too hot.
The
Scheibe got too hot, so I'm going to hold it and hopefully...
You're going to hold it?
Yeah, it'll be a bit better. So we do apologise for that. I thought it was the connection went, but it just came up and said the phone is too hot, and I suppose it would be being in behind the windscreen, and then the sun today, 14.5. And that number plate is from Slovenia, a car from Slovenia.
So many foreign cars. Apparently Banja Luka is fully packed.
So at least I can do some of this now.
Somebody from Germany. Austria, Germany, Slovenia, Austria, American.
So this is
Serbia.
We'll move forward and go to the traffic light, then we'll turn left, and then hopefully the picture quality will get better. It might be a bit waggly because I'm having to hold it, but I've never actually seen that before on this phone, that it switched off because it got too hot. Anyway.
You need to change your phone, David. That works in hot weather. What about if you would live in Egypt?
Yeah, well, I think
Dubai.
I don't know, maybe if
how would you film from Burj Khalifa then?
If we were in so Dubai, we'd most probably have the phone wrapped in ice or something. So here we go.
Here we go, things are getting better.
People are joining again. Dyer's back. Yeah, guys, it's because the phone overheated being in the windscreen.
And it is a winter here, but we have crazy hot day today.
It is a crazy hot day today.
There's a police car.
There's a police car.
Right
there. That's the police car.
Not allowed to film.
And police. Yes, you can film the police. And that
not
big
Subski police.
And that big advertising there is for Chivap. So, as I say, please bear with the shaky camera because I'm holding it's no longer in a fixed position.
See, we have the road signs in two letters, Latinic and Cyrillic.
I wonder Latinic if I can. Oh, I can zoom in. Look at that! How clever.
Yeah,
can you see that?
Latinic is for everybody who doesn't read Cyrillic.
Yeah. Obviously. So there it is. It says center, and above that is Cyrillic for center. And we're going to turn left and go to Kota Varoš. Let's go back in again. Get rid of that sun.
Now it's going to get better.
Now it should get a bit better.
So how many people do we have watching?
We have three watching. They've coming back again, so I'm just going to zoom in. Maybe that'll be better. Yeah, look at
zoom
that.
Up.
And that's it. Now we don't get the dashboard so much. And this is a very green city in the summer. It's just like to die for. Beautiful green everywhere. There's an elementary school. That's what a local school looks like.
That's a big one, actually.
That is a big one. And I think I might, Tamara will tell me if I'm right or wrong, but a lot of the schools are named after people.
Yes, after people's heroes.
Partisans, people's heroes, yeah.
Partisans or famous writers or...
I'm going to go up onto this road sign now. Hopefully we're going to stop and you can see. We have electric charging points in the city as well. So it's... Tamara hates roundabouts. It's the British influence, I think.
I don't know. They are everywhere around me now. I hate them.
So I hope you're enjoying this little trip.
It's not a big thing in North America, I think.
I don't know.
Roundabouts.
I think Mickey said, do they have roundabouts in Australia, down under? I wonder what it's like down under.
Down under. Maybe. Oh, my shoulder hurts. We're not far away from the shopping center.
Gotta go have a very nice
look at
new
this
year.
Traffic today. Oh my god, this is crazy.
So,
what's the time?
Di's had to go. See you later. Have a nice new year, Di. Our great friend Mickey Regalich says they have roundabouts in Australia.
Ah, they do. Don't remember seeing many in Canada. I lived there for 7 years. There's a new shopping center on the left, but we're not going there.
No, we're not going to go there because we'll spend too much money.
And time. It's huge.
And time.
So walking in there could be a total workout.
Yeah. So this is Delta Planet, one of the biggest shopping centers in Banja Luka. In fact, the biggest.
The biggest, yeah.
Yeah.
That's like an American style. Shopping
center. It's a mall.
Mall, yeah, it's like a mall. Yeah. It's huge.
I'm gonna try and.
We used to never have them like this before. Back in the communist day, we used to just have like shops.
In the communist time, you just had take it or leave it, wasn't it?
Yeah, take it or leave it, or fly away from here. Not much choice, trust me, people, not much choice.
So we'll
another roundabout.
We'll be coming to the end of our two-part trip.
They should give names to these roundabouts.
If you're seeing this in catch-up, if you want to give us some questions in the comments, I will get back to everybody. So we're going to a shopping centre called Mercator. We're going to branch right now, and then we're going to go into an underground car park where the signal's going to go. So, from me and Tam, have a happy new year. And
have a happy new year, wherever you are. Enjoy it with your family.
And we'll catch you next year.
We'll catch you soon. Bye.
Here we go. I wonder how long it lasts. Let's just see.
There's a parking spot there.
Have you found a parking spot?
I think I did.